Ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, good afternoon. Assalamu alaikum. Minasama, konnichiwa. Welcome to the Japan premiere screening of Tiny Souls, which is part of the Lest We Forget exhibition displayed just outside these doors. We are delighted to have you at JICA Global Plaza this evening, and without any further ado, allow me to ask Her Excellency Ambassador Lina, Ambassador of Jordan to Japan, to present her welcoming speech.
Thank you, Talal, San, for this introduction. Minasama, konnichiwa, Ms. Karen Farkas, UNHCR representative in Japan, Mr. Hideki, Matsunaga, JICA Director General of Middle East and Europe Department, esteemed ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Can you hear me well? Okay. Thank you all for being here today to be part of the Japan premiere screening of Tiny Souls movie by Jordanian director Dina Naser, as well as of the exhibition Lest We Forget by the Jordanian two-time Pulitzer Prize winner, photojournalist Muhammed Muheisen. Both of these events aim to shed light on one of the most pressing issues facing the world today, and that is the plight of 70 million people who have been forcibly displaced from their homes by conflicts, persecution, illegal land occupation, and other forms of oppression worldwide. Out of these 70 million, an estimated 26 million people are refugees. Syrian refugees alone, the focus of today's events, account for the majority of world refugees with over 6 million people. Most of these refugees are vulnerable groups of women and children. In today's movie, we will witness a real slice of life of a Syrian refugee family in Za'atri camp who fled the conflict in Syria and found safe haven in my country, Jordan. Today's movie will also highlight the colossal and at times extremely difficult measures and decisions facing refugee host communities in ensuring the safety, security, and well-being of the hosted refugees. Tiny Souls movie takes place in Za'atri camp, located in north of Jordan and just few kilometers away from the Syrian border. It is the largest Syrian camp in the world, and with almost 80,000 residents, it is close to being Jordan's fourth largest city. Ironically, over the past few years, Za'atri has become the poster camp of Syrian refugees. It is the most filmed and photographed refugee camp in the world. But photographs are frames that capture a moment in time. They tell part of an ongoing story. As important as they are, putting them in full context becomes even more important. Ladies and gentlemen, as we gather today, it is crucial that we set the scene in its proper context in order to understand the full extent of the challenges facing the refugees, as well as their host communities and countries. Over the past few decades, it has become all too clear that refugees are disproportionately hosted, not by wealthy nations, but by poor and middle-income countries next to their own. And this holds true to Jordan. Jordan is a relatively small country. I like to think of it as a small country with a big heart, thanks to the love and compassion that it has been extending for years to its neighbors in need. The size of Jordan is almost the size of Hokkaido Prefecture. The population of Jordan is estimated at 10 million, out of which a staggering 3.5 million people are refugees. In percentages, 34% of Jordan's population are refugees. 28% of them are either registered with UNHCR or with UNRWA, the UN agency in charge of Palestinian refugees. put this in relative terms, it is as if a country like Japan hosted 35 million refugees. In fact, and despite of its meager resources and the many socioeconomic and geopolitical challenges it faces, Jordan is considered today to be one of the highest refugee population per capita in the world. Syrians fleeing the conflict in Syria and seeking safe shelter in Jordan are estimated at 1.3 million people, or almost 13% of the total population. There are about 660,000 Syrians registered with UNHCR in Jordan. Jordan has been carrying a massive burden as a refugee host. The influx of Syrian refugees has put huge pressure on the kingdom's natural and physical resources. And in spite of all of this, Jordan continues to shoulder the refugee challenge, keeping with its compassionate and humanitarian traditions. This was evident during the current pandemic. Since the beginning of COVID-19, all refugees in Jordan are included in the National Health Response Plan and are able to access the National Health Services on par with Jordanian nationals. As of November 10th, the total number of refugees that have tested positive for COVID-19 in Jordan's refugee camps reached 672 persons, out of which 503 have recovered. No deaths have been reported. While the number of refugee cases has increased, it remains lower than the national average, with less than 1% of the refugee population testing positive, while compared to 1.1% of the total Jordanian population. Thanks to the wonderful organizations such as UNHCR and the World Health Organization, and under the leadership of Jordan's Ministry of Health, and the generous funding and support of donors such as Japan through the enormous work of JICA, key measures to contain the control the spread to control to contain and control the spread of the virus in refugee camps were put in place from the onset of the pandemic. These include construction of quarantine facilities, boosting health screening procedures, providing PPEs for frontline workers as well as refugees, and extending emergency assistance to over 50,000 vulnerable families, and also support access to e-learning platforms. And as we speak of Japan, it is also worth noting that recently Japan initiated what is called Japanese Initiative for the Future of Syrian Refugees, JICR, which offers 20 scholarship slots for Syrian refugees in Jordan and Lebanon to complete their master's degree in Japanese universities, which I believe is a fantastic opportunity for refugees to be able to attain higher education in such reputable universities as the Japanese ones. Ladies and gentlemen, we in Jordan want to help. We want to provide safe haven, and we want to provide all the needed services to those badly in need. But we cannot do this on our own. The world must come together to shoulder this massive responsibility. Host countries and communities have stretched their resources thin for the sake of providing safety to those whose lives have been shattered by conflicts and brutal circumstances. It was encouraging to see mention of refugees in the leaders' declaration of the latest G20 summit a few days ago hosted by Saudi Arabia. It listed inclusion and tackling of inequalities as part of its agreed on list of actions. It specifically mentioned migration and forced displacement as a topic of concern, while highlighting shared actions in three important areas. The first area is mitigation of the impact of the pandemic on those in vulnerable situations, which include refugees, migrants, and forcibly displaced people. The second one is responding to their growing humanitarian needs. And the third one is addressing the root causes of their displacement. On the third note of addressing root causes, and amid this dual global humanitarian crisis of being refugees in times of a pandemic, we should never lose sight of the fact that the tragedy of displaced persons is, as UNHCR High Commissioner Mr. Filippo Grandi described it, and I quote here, a symptom of a world without peace. As the world looks for ways to help, we must also become more mindful and efficient in stopping wars. Finally, gathering like ours today prompt us to ask ourselves, what does it mean when people lose ties with their hometowns and families? What does it mean when they continue to live with memories after that? In essence, a person with a home will probably never fully understand the feelings of a homeless person. I would like to end my talk today by quoting Japanese writer Yu Miri, who won this year's National Book Award for Translated Literature in the United States for her novel Tokyo Ueno Station. Her novel depicts the life of the book's narrator Kazu, who left his family in Fukushima Prefecture to work as a laborer in the capital in preparation for the 1964 Tokyo Olympics, and who lived in a vast homeless village in Ueno Park in central Tokyo. Commenting on her award, Miri said, and I quote, "I wonder how many people who heard the phrase stay home during the pandemic actually thought of those who do not have homes," end quote. I also wonder what stay home meant and still means for the millions of innocent refugees who dream of going back home and staying there. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the movie.
Thank you, Ambassador. May I ask Mr. Hideki Matsunaga, Director General of the Middle East and Europe Department at JICA, to deliver his welcoming speech.
皆さん、こんにちは。JICA中東支部の松永と申します。本日はこのような素晴らしいですね、映画の上映会を帯写真展をですね、企画いただきました、リンダーナーブ、駐日ヨルダン大使、そして、カレン・ファルカス、ユネチアル駐日代表をはじめ、準備をしていただいた方々に心から御礼申し上げております。ちょっとここで英語にスイッチさせていただきたいと思います。 Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Hideki Matsunaga, working for the JICA, Middle East and Europe Department. Thank you very much for, first of all, you know, I really would like to express our sincere gratitude for organizing this movie event, as well as a photo exhibition. And my thanks goes to Her Excellency Lina, Annab, and also Karen Farkas, head of the UNHCR in Tokyo. It was really marvelous remarks made by Her Excellency Ambassador Lina Annab. And Jordan has been hosting so many Syrians since 2011 from the outbreak of the conflict in Syria. And the number, as it was projected by Her Excellency, official registered number is more than 200,000, but unofficial number is beyond 1 million. That's a huge number. However, Jordan has been providing so much services to those refugees, such as education, health, and infrastructure. I myself lived in Jordan from 2004 to 2006. And during that time, there are so many Iraqi refugees who fled from Iraq. And at that time, Jordan was hosting those Iraqi refugees. In the past, Jordan has hosted so many Palestinian refugees for several decades, and the Jordan people still live together with those Palestinian refugees. And really, have to, you know, express our thankfulness to generosity to Jordan, you know, supporting those people suffering, as well as providing global public goods on behalf of the international community. That said, we have a concern. As Syrian crisis is lasting so long, and because of this ongoing COVID crisis, the international community sometimes forget about the crisis of, you know, those refugee crises. In such a time, I think, you know, hosting this kind of group movie event, as well as a photo exhibition, has very, very special meanings. Some of you might have seen the photos exhibited outside, and you might have, you know, looked at those children's photo as well as eyes. You know, they are trying to tell us something. And the title of this photo exhibition was, you know, in Japanese, Watashi tachi wo wasumenai. You know, we should not really forget what those children's eyes are telling us. We JICA try to feel very sensitively what they are trying to, you know, tell us. And we'd like to try our best to support those children and refugees in need, as well as the host communities who are hosting those refugees. At the age of COVID-19 crisis, the concept of human security, which focuses on the people's, you know, individuals' lives and livelihood, are recognized as an important concept. The former High Commissioner of UNHCR, as well as the President of JICA, late Mrs. Sadako Ogata, was a strong proponent of this concept of human security. And now really is a time to revisit that concept and reflect on it. In that connection, Jordan is a country who has been executing this concept of human security through supporting so many refugees from Syria, Iraq, and Palestine. And we are very thankful for this. And today's event is really the occasion we will reflect again what the role we can play and what we should do to support, you know, those people and children suffering. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Matsunaga. May I ask Ms. Karen Farkas, UNHCR's representative in Japan, to deliver her welcoming speech.
Her Excellency Ambassador Lina, Mr. Hideki Matsunaga of JICA, Middle East and Europe Department, distinguished guests. Konnichiwa. I am very honored to be here today to attend the Japan premiere screening of the documentary Tiny Souls, which sadly reminds us all through the eyes of children that the Syrian crisis is well into its 10th year and is one of the most pressing issues facing the world today. Countries hosting Syrian refugees play important roles in the response to the Syrian crisis. They provide millions of refugees safety and protection while also contributing to efforts to resolve conflicts and restore peace so that conditions are created for refugees to one day return home. The Hashemite Kingdom of Jordan is one such country. For many years now, the government and local communities have shown considerable generosity in receiving thousands of refugees from neighboring countries. Jordan currently hosts 750,000 refugees, predominantly Syrian, representing the second largest refugee population per capita globally. COVID-19 has brought additional challenges, and UNHCR and its partners are grateful to the kingdom and the people of Jordan for the inclusion of refugees into the National Health Response Plan so that they may receive care and treatment where and when it is needed. Hosting so many refugees is, however, a considerable challenge, and international assistance continues to be urgently required. In this regard, Japan has played a lead role in supporting humanitarian action throughout the world, including in the Kingdom of Jordan. Japanese contributions have helped refugees living in urban areas and in Safari and Azlat camps to engage with their communities and cope with everyday challenges through the strong community support structure provided by the UNHCR-run community centers. Funding from the government of Japan has also helped address health and winterization for many vulnerable refugees. And through JICA, many Syrian refugees have benefited from livelihood and self-employment skills training and income opportunities, as well as scholarships to continue their education in graduate programs at universities in Japan. closing, distinguished guests, thank you for coming today. And on behalf of UNHCR and the people we serve, I would like to express our sincere gratitude to the Kingdom of Jordan and to the government and people of Japan for your generous and continuing support. Arigatou gozaimasu.